Hey guys, I'm Reginald. I'm also known as DEMCAD. First, the Obama secret kill list. Well, I guess it's not a secret anymore. This kill list is designed by the Obama administration, and apparently they've given themselves the authority to take people out without a trial. Now, when it comes to U.S. citizens, how do these people have the authority to kill U.S. citizens without any type of trial or anything? I mean, that's one big issue right there. Another issue is that some of these guys, particularly one of these Americans who were recently killed, it seemed like the guy was just a trash talker. And then once they took him out, they upgraded him to something greater or bigger than he actually was. You know, another issue is, okay, are they able to take these people out without actually hurting innocent people? And do they actually care about that? It's not a surprise coming from the Obama administration. The guy has been consistently lying. The guy has consistently pushed a neocon type of foreign policy. He came into office saying that he was going to shut down Guantanamo Bay. He obviously didn't. He signed the papers to do so. But then his political party, he's claiming that the Congress didn't allow him to do so. But his party controlled both chambers of Congress. They had large majorities for his first 2 years in office. So, I mean, that's complete nonsense. If he wanted that Guantanamo Bay to get shut down, it would have been shut down. The guy escalated the war in Afghanistan, almost tripled the amount of soldiers sent into Afghanistan. That's become a disaster. This is right before he received his Nobel Peace Prize. The guy protected the Bush torturers, claiming that, well, these are state secrets and this shouldn't be under a judicial review. You know, he was backed up by a circuit court, I believe. One of those courts he was backed up by. What else? he also signed a Patriot Act. He re-signed the Patriot Act. You know, so it's not a big surprise. With that said, you know, Europe. Situation in Europe is not getting any better. The Spanish retailers, I think they went down by, what, 9.8%? 9.8% in a year-to-year sales in April. So basically their sales in April were 9.8% lower than their sales the last April, which is pretty significant. While this is happening, you have European firms preparing for a Greece exit. They're preparing for this inevitable event. You have Dixon, an electronic retailer that has about 100 stores in Greece. They're now stockpiling shutters to actually secure their windows and stuff. Okay, so they're trying to secure their property. This is something that preppers have been talking about for years. You know, there's also drug makers, a British drug company that's working with some European officials to get drugs. They're working on an emergency plan to get drugs into the country. So when this happens, they can be better prepared. You know, this is stuff that preppers have been talking about for years. But, you know, a lot of people say that, oh, we're alarmists. But this is proof that, hey, companies, they prepare. No matter what you say about preppers, companies prepare. Anyway, the U.S. 10-year yield hit a record low of 1.63%. Incredible. What else is going on here in the U.S.? Oh, pending home sales. They dropped 5.5% in April. In March, the housing prices went down by 2.6%. These are indexes, by the way. Case-Shiller was reporting the actual home prices going down 2.6%. So, I mean, part of that problem is that you need real jobs for people to be able to buy up these houses and stabilize the market. But that's obviously not happening. So that's why you have a situation where, you know, they're saying, oh, unemployment is getting better. But we still have like 46-something million people collecting food stamps. It's getting better, you know. The housing market, which tanked, it's still tanking. But hey, it's getting better. Don't worry, everything is under control. What else is going on? Oh, radioactive tuna. Fukushima. Well, scientists, a lot of them are convinced, well, some of them are convinced that this radioactive tuna, and by the way, they're saying that the amount found in the tuna is very tiny, and it's still safe to eat. But turns out this tuna that they recovered had radioactive materials that was 10 times greater than what they found the previous year. that's really fascinating, because they still insist that, you know, the food is safe to eat. And, you know, this summer we're going to find out, because they're going to be looking at fish that were exposed to the same radioactive areas 3 times as long as a fish that tested 10 times higher than the previous years. So I'm not saying the fish isn't safe to eat. I am saying that obviously there's a lot more radiation in the food, and so people are blaming it on Fukushima. It's surprising, because this fish is supposed to be able to shed a lot of that stuff, and it travels 6,000 miles. They found this on near California, near the coast of California. Fish, tuna, that actually had 10 times the level of radiations, cesium, than detected years before. So I'm not saying the world's going to come to an end, but I am saying that, you know, there's consequences for the things that we do. I'm not writing off nuclear energy altogether, but given Japan's limitations as far as where they're located at and their exposure to earthquakes, maybe they should look for an alternative. Because right now we're using nuclear fission. We're separating atoms, and that creates nuclear waste. But if we can develop nuclear fusion, that could be a lot more safer, because then we don't have to contend with all that waste. Right now, once we have these spent fuel rods in these nuclear plants, we don't have a really safe place to put this stuff. And this stuff takes a long time to really degrade. So you guys tell me what you think. Is nuclear energy something we should write off? I think it's time for a big jump in technology. We need to develop some safer, cleaner, more efficient technologies. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Yeah, I really appreciate you guys who go to my channel every day looking for updates. I mean, this is what really keeps the channel going. And I just like to thank you guys.